Welcome learners, today we want to look at organic chemistry 1, particularly ethynes. Alkynes are unsaturated hydrocarbons. Due to presence of a triple bond and at least two adjacent carbon atoms, as shown, we have a carbon atom, then you have a double bond, then you put a bond here and a bond here to make 4-4. The general formula of alkynes is given by CnH2n minus 2, where n is the number of carbon atoms. Next, you look at nomenclature. Alkynes are named by joining a prefix indicating the number of carbon atoms, to a suffix yne. For example, when n is equals to 5, the prefix is pend. You join to a suffix yne, you get pentyne. The molecular formula is given by C5. Then you say 2 times 5 minus 2 gives you 8. So H8. Now the open structural formula for that, you draw 5 carbon atoms and at least 2 adjacent carbon atoms, you have a triple bond. So I draw 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then at least 2 adjacent carbon atoms, I have a triple bond. Then the rest become single bonds. Then you make each of them to have 4 bonds, each carbon. So I don't place any line here because it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I place one single line here. And then I place hydrogen in each of the bonds created, hydrogen atoms. Now that's called open structure formula. Condensed structural formula from this one will be, take this C, there's a single hydrogen, so it becomes CH. The second one has no hydrogen, so just a C only. The next one is, this one is CH2, this one is CH2 here. So we have CH2 brackets 2, and the last one is CH3. So this is called condensed structure formula. Now the next we look at is naming of branch alkynes. Now next we look at this naming of branch alkynes, whereby you have to know the guidelines for naming a branch alkyne, the same as those ones of alkenes, whereby the first one you say is identify the longest continuous carbon chain. Number 2, number the carbon atom from the end near the triple bond. 3, locate position of the branches. In that, between a name and numeral, you separate by hyphen. Between numerals, you separate by comma. For more than one similar branch, use di for 2, tri for 3, tetra for 4. For more than one different branch, name them alphabetically. That is, if you have methyl, bromo, chloro. Start with bromo, then chloro, then methyl. Now, do not use capital letters between names. For example, you're told to give the IUPAC name for this compound here. So I say the step one is to identify the longest continuous carbon chain. So the longest continuous carbon chain is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can also say 1, 2, 3. Can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the longest has 5 carbon atoms, so the prefix of the parent name will be pent. Now in the name of the parent name, you have to show position of the triple bond name. So that brings you what they call numbering of the carbon atoms. It should begin from the end near the triple bonds. Now if I begin from the left hand side here, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The double bond, the triple bond is here is carbon number 2 and 3. is by beginning on the right hand side is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The triple bond is carbon number 4 and 5. So that means therefore now my numbering begins from the left hand side, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the parent name, I take the lowest number, which is 2, become pent, Ivan, 2, Ivan, Ein. Now the branches we have, this is a bromo branch, this is a bromo branch, and this is a methyl branch. So because we have 2 bromo, I say use di. So it becomes here, the branches we have 4 methyl, and then we have 4,5 Ivan dibromo. So the name of this compound will be, name them alphabetically. So I started bromo. So it will be 4,5 Ivan dibromo Ivan 4 Ivan methyl pend Ivan 2 Ivan then ein. If you want to look at this isomerism of alkynes, isomerism is defined as existence of two or more compounds with the same molecular formula but different structural formula. Isomers are two or more compounds with the same molecular formula but different structural formula. There will be two types of isomerism, that is positional isomerism and branching isomerism. Positional isomerism is obtained by changing position of the triple bond. For example, you are told draw and name any two positional isomers of butyne. So butyne, the molecular formula of butyne is C4. Then you say two times 4 is 8 minus 2 is 6. So H6. So now to draw the positional isomers, I draw 4 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. In the first isomer, I place a triple bond here. Then the rest become single bonds. Then make each of them to have 4 bonds. Here no bonds placed. And here, and then I place hydrogen here. Hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. Now to draw the next isomer positional, to draw the next positional isomer, I draw 4 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I change position of the triple bonds to be at this point here. Then the rest become single bonds. Then I make them to be 4 bonds each, so I place here 3. So no bonds placed here because they're already 3 plus this is 4. No bonds placed here because this 1 and this 3, 4. Then I place here 4 bonds. Then hydrogen, 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 then hydrogen. So this first one is called what? I begin numbering from here. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's called but, Ivan, 1, Ivan, ein. Second one is called here. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's called but, Ivan, 2, Ivan, ein. This type of isomerism is called branching isomerism. This one is obtained by changing, by modifying the structural formula of the preceding isomer. For example, I'm told, draw and name any two branch isomers of pentyne. Pentyne, first of all, I draw the molecular formula. First of all, I write the molecular formula. Pentyne is C5H8. Now, in the first isomer, I draw the normal chain, 5 carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Place the triple bond here, then the rest become single bonds. So I place here an H, H there, H, 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 H there, then H there. Now, when you're drawing the next isomer, you remove the carbon atom, which has got 3 hydrogen atoms, so it will form what you call methyl. So if I remove this one here, I remain with 4 carbon atoms. So I draw So I draw four carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then there was a triple bond here. The rest become single bonds. And then make each carbon to have four bonds. Here don't place any, then you place here one. Now the one that you removed was called a methyl branch. You place it in the middle of the chain, not at the end, not here, not here. So you should place here CH3, and the rest you make it hydrogen atoms. So this first compound here is called pentyne. This one, you start numbering from here. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a methyl branch. So it becomes 3-ivan-methyl-but-ivan-1-ivan-ine. Now, after looking at that, we look at how to prepare ethyne. Ethyne, the reagents used to prepare ethyne are water and calcium carbide. The reaction occur as follows. Calcium carbide plus water gives you calcium hydroxide plus ethyne gas. The chemical equation for that is calcium carbide 2 solid plus water liquid gives you calcium hydroxide aqueous plus ethyne C2H2. It's a gas. Balance the question, put here 2. Now this gas is usually collected by over water methods because it's lightly soluble in water. It's advisable not to collect the initial amount of gas because it is impure, that is, it is mixed with air originally in the flask. Now before starting this experiment, it's always advisable, you're told, to ensure the flask is dry. The reason is to prevent formation of ethyne gas before the setup is complete. Now the setup diagram below shows preparation of ethyne gas in the laboratory. So water is placed on top here. And then before place the sand here, the role of sand is to absorb excessive heat produced because the reaction between calcium carbide and water is exothermic. And then you place the ethyne. When water is allowed inside here, the reaction takes place. And I said the initial amount of gas will be collected. And then the gas collected over water here. So this is ethyne gas collected here. So learners, in the next lesson, we're going to look at physical properties of alkynes and the chemical properties of alkynes. Thank you.